Welcome back, students. So, we will be continuing from where we left in the last class, that is revaluation account. As we discussed in the last class, that all the losses are to be debited in revaluation account and all the profits are to be credited in revaluation account. Let us understand these by way of few examples. Point number one, unrecorded investment, if it is given, it will be credited in revaluation account. Why? Because unrecorded investment is now a profit for the firm. It was not recorded earlier. So, now it is a gain for us. So, it is credit. You just have to remember one thing, if it is a loss, it will be debited. If it is a profit, it is going to be credited. Right? Now, let us understand it by another example. You have to think about it and then I will write. You think within 1 second. Unrecorded liability, the liability which was not recorded earlier. Yes, it is a loss, it will be debited. Similarly, think about creditors which are not likely to arise. Creditors which do not have to make any payment. Yes, it is a gain for you. So, it will be credited. Any increase in the value of asset. Yes, it is a profit for you. And any decrease in liability, yes, it is again profit for you. So, both are to be credited. Let us do some more questions. Point number 6, increase in the provision for doubtful debt. That means, we will not be getting some of our debtors. Now, that is a loss. Yes, it will be debited in revaluation account. Now, increase in the provision for discount on creditors, which means we will not be paying to the creditors and that is a gain for the business and it will be, yes, credited. Now, what about valueless asset? The assets which are not having any value. Yes, it is a loss for you. So, it will be debited. And what about valueless liabilities? Valueless liability means you do not have to pay for them. So, it is a gain for you and that will be credited. If we are accepting a third party claim of damages, which was earlier not written in the books and now you are accepting it, it means you have to pay for it and that will be a loss for you and that is going to be debited. I have already written debited, right? Yes, coming to one more topic, that is memorandum revaluation account. First of all, let us understand what is this memorandum revaluation account. Let us see point by point. Point number one, if we are not to show the changes in the value of asset and liability except capital and cash, this means whatever values you have changed in the assets and liability, you do not want to show them in the balance sheet, then we have to make a part 2 of revaluation account, which is called memorandum revaluation account. Please see the next point. Entries are reversed in the second part. For example, if I am writing something on the debit side of the revaluation account, in the part 2, I will write it on the credit side. Similarly, if I am writing on the credit side in part 1, I will write on the debit side of part 2. Why? We will come to it. Next point. If part 1 you are getting profit, then in part 2 it will be reversed. That is, you will get a loss. Very simple. If in part 1 we are getting profit, if we reverse all the entries, what you will get? Loss. Simple. Part 1 is distributed among old partners and part 2 will be distributed between all partners. Now, this is the catch. Part 1 for old and part 2 for all. Now, this will negate the effect of revaluation account and it will give the old partners an edge over the new partner. Let's see what is the effect of this memorandum revaluation account. When in part 1, profit is distributed between old partners in old ratio. Please see the boxes carefully. Between old partners in old ratio. And in part 2, loss is distributed between all, including new partner in the new ratio. What is the net effect of all this is? Net effect is equal to new partner is debited and old partners get credited, which is our main motive. Why? Because when the old partners have earned some profit, and in the second part when we are transferring loss to them, we will transfer a little bit of less loss as compared to the more profit in part 1. Now, this will do one thing, that new partner will be debited with some particular amount and old partners will be credited with some particular amount. The increase in the value of assets or decrease in the value of liability or vice versa will be adjusted through the capital account rather than going through the formalities of changing the balance sheet. Right? Once again, let us recapitulate. What we have understood is memorandum revaluation account will negate the first part effect in the part 2, and it will have an effect that new partner will get debited and the old partner will get credited, and we will share that particular effect with the new partner without bringing the change in the balance sheet. This will be clearly understood when we will do a full question on that. But let us discuss the theory part first. The next point is, if there are some reserves, accumulated profits or losses given in the balance sheet at the time of admission of a partner, what to do with that? Reserves, accumulated profits, accumulated losses existing in the old balance sheet. Who has a right on all these things? Yes, old partners. So, we will distribute them to the old partners. Let us see. Old partners have a right on that. So, they are credited with the profits and reserves, and if accumulated losses are there, they are debited, because whatever is before admission belongs to old partners only. A very, very important topic in your exams is adjustment of capital. There are 2-3 methods on this. First, adjusting the capital on the basis of new partner. Whatever new partner is bringing in cash, we will adjust the capital of old partners accordingly. And if they have any surplus, we will refund to them. And if they have any deficit, they will bring it in the business. Let us see. First point, if it is on the basis of new partner capital and his share shall be calculated, which is already given in the question. On the basis of this, calculate what should be the share of existing partners and then compare their actual capital after adjustment of goodwill, revaluation, reserves, losses, etc. It means when we have to compare the capital of old partners, it should be after all the adjustments given in the question. Maybe it is revaluation, accumulated profits, accumulated losses, goodwill, whatever adjustments are there, you have to first do that and then see what is the actual balance, and then you compare it with what it should be. Yes, please see the next point. Find the difference then. If the difference is that they have to bring, they will bring the money, and if the difference is they are already having more, then we will pay them back or refund them. Yes. If the capital of a partner is less than required, he brings additional cash, and vice versa. If the capital is more, he is refunded that extra money. But please note one thing, if it is specified in the question that we have to do this adjustment through capital or current account, then we will not refund the cash or we will not bring the cash. It will be adjusted through the current account. Please note, if it is mentioned in the question, only then. Otherwise, you have to refund the cash or you have to bring the additional cash. Let us understand this by way of an example, because this point can only be understood with the help of an example. Please see, A and B are old partners with the ratio 3 and 2. C is admitted as a new partner with 1/4 share and a capital of 50,000. Please see, C share is 1/4 and capital is 50,000. Now, A capital after all the adjustment is 70,000 and B capital after all the adjustment is 65,000. I have already given the adjusted capital so that you are able to get this point only, right? Now, let us solve this question. Total capital of the firm should be 2 lakh because C was having 1/4 share for 50,000. So, that means total capital will be 2 lakh. Now, please deduct C capital from this 50,000. That makes the balance 1,50,000, which the capital of A and B should be. Let us see what the capital of A should be. 1,50,000 into A's share 3/5, that is 90,000, and B capital should be 1,50,000 into 2/5, that is 60,000. Now, this should be their capital. And what is their actual capital? That was given in the question itself, 70,000 and 65,000. Compare this 70,000 with 90,000. So, A must bring 20,000 more, and B, who is already having 5,000 more, he must be refunded 5,000 rupees. I hope you are able to understand. If any partner is having more capital, he must be refunded. And if a partner is having less capital, he shall bring the additional capital to make it proportionate. So, this we have shown here. A will bring rupees 20,000, 90,000 minus 70,000, and B will be refunded 5,000, that is 65,000 minus 60,000. Otherwise, if mentioned, it can be transferred to current account. A current account will be debited because he has to pay to the organization, and B current account will be credited because we have to pay back to B. So, paying back to B is a liability and taking back from A is an asset. So, current account will be debited when we have to take. Current account will be credited when the firm has to give to that partner. Now, the second point regarding adjustment of capital is, when total capital is already given for the firm and what is required is capital of all partners should be in a specific ratio. Let us understand point by point. First point is, distribute the capital required as per the ratio. Make it as a balance which should be carried down, because it should be the last balance carried down, and bring or refund as the case may be. Let us understand this by way of an example. Yes, the example is ABC 3:1 ratio, old partners. D is admitted for 1/4 share. Total capital of the firm should be 1,20,000. Now, this is the question. How much D will bring? 30,000, because 1,20,000 into 1/4 is 30,000, and A capital should be the remaining 90,000 into his share 3/6, 45,000. B capital should be 90,000 into 2 by 6, that is 30,000, and C capital should be 90,000 into 1 by 6, that is 15,000. Now, see, this makes it 120,000. Now, this should be their capital. If anybody is having less capital, he will bring that amount, and if anybody is having more capital than this, he will be refunded the money. So, what we have understood in today's discussion is that when capital adjustments are to be made, it can be on the basis of old partner or it can be pre-decided capital also. In the next class, we will be dealing with another aspect of this, that is when we have to do adjustment according to the old partner's capital and what the new partner shall bring. We will decide on this question in our next class. Till then, goodbye all of you.